So now we'll move on to these innovative fingerings. In figure 9, this is a classic case where I've seen many teachers look at this music, and if you look at the first two notes there in figure 9 on the upper line, this is Ysaÿe's published fingerings, of a 1 and then a 2. Well, this is typical in Ysaÿe, where he would take a normally just regular passage of two notes that can be played just by neighboring fingers, and he puts in a deliberate slide, having to slide back from the 1 to the 2. And you think, well, why does he do this? That 1 must be a misprint. So many teachers have changed it to a 3, as you can see below in the quote conservative fingerings that I created. So what I've done is I put fingerings in here on the bottom line, but as though the music never had any fingerings at all, and I just added what would be a typical set of conventional fingerings. I'm going to play this passage for you now, and you'll see how it would sound normally. Now I'm going to add this fingering, so you'll see what we're talking about. Again, this is a window into the kind of playing that was going on during Ysaÿe's day. And it's this wonderful capsule that we have in all of this music that we can play these kinds of fingerings.
Moment. And of course, there are super chords in most of his sonatas. Here's sonata number 4.